Hi, my name is Vinay Krishna Sharma. I'll be presenting our work on eye gaze controlled robotic arm for persons with speech and motor impairment. This work is done under the supervision of Dr. Pradeep Viswas in the Intelligent Inclusive Interaction Design Lab at CPDM in IISc. The lab members belong to all different backgrounds. I personally work on human-robot interaction, which is the study of robotic systems which are designed or developed to be used by humans. It is also known by other names like man-machine interaction, human-machine interaction, and human-robot collaboration. In the i3D lab, we are making solutions for education and infotainment of users with speech and motor impairment. Such persons face challenges in natural hand, speech, and gesture movements. For communication, persons with SSMI use display charts like the ones you see on the screen, where the trainer has to analyze the user's eye gaze based on what the user wants to say, maybe a yes and no, if he wants to drink water or not, or maybe if he wants to say a complete word, then we might have to look at these clusters where the user is looking at. To complement the shortcomings of persons with speech and motor impairment, we wanted to deploy a human-robot interaction system which can allow the users to pick and place, to draw, to manipulate some objects in the environment using just their eye gaze. So we worked with Vidya Sagar School in Chennai, and we did some user trials on the users, which belong to all different age groups, all different genders, and had different educational backgrounds. The important point was that they do not have any finger movement or like head isolations or speech. So the only the most prominent mode of interaction was eye gaze. So we wanted to analyze eye gaze as a modality to interact with a robot to pick and place something in the environment. We designed two user studies. First one was a pick and drop task where the user had to use his or her eye gaze to pick and place shuttlecocks in the robot environment. And the second one was the reachability study where the user had to reach a randomly assigned target from a starting point using just his eye gaze.
We have developed an eye gaze controlled video see-through interface to control a robotic arm. The system found applications for people with severe speech and motor impairment. Users with severe motor impairment could undertake simple pick and drop tasks using our interface. The robotic arm moves based on their saccadic gaze movement, and they can dwell on a screen region for picking and placing an object.
The results of this study were quite fascinating, as all the 18 participants were able to complete the task successfully, and as far as the task completion time was concerned, there was no significant difference found between the persons with SSMI and able-bodied persons. So shows a person trying to pick and place shuttlecocks from desired locations to desired destination using just the eye gaze. Next, the reachability study, where the user had to reach to a randomly assigned target from the center of the circle, and the user can just use the four-way controls. So the user can move the robot in just four perpendicular directions, which is like up, down, left, and right. And the results were also like quite motivating, as all 12 participants were able to complete the task successfully. And we also noted that in the second session, the performance of the persons with SSMI improved significantly.
Our end users with severe motor impairment are already involved with fabric printing activities with the help of an able-bodied person. Our eye gaze controlled interface can enable these users to undertake such job independently. They can move the robotic arm anywhere in its working envelope through eye gaze and can make a print by dwelling at the middle icon of the screen. Our user study found that they can bring the arm at any precise location using our interface.
This video shows an actual severe speech and motor impaired user using our proposed system to move a robotic arm from a randomly assigned starting point to a designated target using the four-way control displayed on the augmented user interface on the Surface Pro tablet, and he completes the task very nicely. In both the previous user studies, we have used a commercially available off-the-shelf eye tracker, which is made by Tobii, which is a leading eye tracker manufacturer. But it is costly. It needs a separate hardware to install, and it is also low latency. But like it cannot be deployed as a mass solution. So we also worked at making a indigenous webcam based eye tracker. And to make the webcam work as an eye tracker, we used open source software called OpenFace, which is a face tracker which gives you head position, head orientation and facial landmarks. And these parameters was used to derived eye vectors for a user when he was asked to look at one of these randomly assigned 9 blocks on the screen. So with this, we were able to achieve track the user's eye gaze on these 9 regions of the screen, and these were like good enough to control a robotic arm in the 4 perpendicular directions. The proposed webcam based eye gaze controller allows the user to control the mouse using just eye gaze, which can be used to browse the internet or maybe type a message or SMS or do a Google search.
We have developed a webcam based eye gaze tracker using OpenFace library. Using that webcam based eye gaze tracker, users can operate the robotic arm through eye gaze without needing any dedicated hardware for eye gaze tracking.
The proposed webcam based eye tracker was used for a reachability study again, where we found that in the second session, the performance of the persons with speech and motor impaired improved significantly. And we thank you, and we want to end this with a video.
We have also integrated computer vision technology with the interface. In this part of the video, the robotic arm can be seen to follow a blue object. The same algorithm can be configured for any particular color or shape of object or a set of markers within the robot's working envelope. The same eye gaze controlled augmented reality display can be extended to other cyber physical systems beyond robotics, like unmanned ground and aerial vehicles. We can drive a car simply by looking at appropriate waypoints in a live video feed, or can run it in semi-autonomous mode towards a target. In the last case, eye gaze can be used to select one of many targets, and the vehicle moves towards the target using computer vision technology. We have used similar principle for unmanned aerial vehicles too. Learning to operate a single interface and interaction technique, users can operate multiple cyber-physical systems.